Children's Health Fund spans 21 sites across the country. Lots of children and their families have been cared for by many caring people.
Listen to your belly.
See me now. You would never think to wonder.
But it hasn't been all business as usual. The mobile units, it seemed, had the ability to provide rapid response to public health crises. We realized this when we came to provide health care for thousands of victims of Category 5 Hurricane Andrew, which smashed into South Florida in 1992.
I think my soul was stuck in amber.
And we did it again in 2001, dispatching units and medical teams to Ground Zero after the terror attacks of 9/11.
But now I'm gone.
And then came Katrina. 100,000 square miles of devastation. More than 1.5 million displaced people. And as Paul Simon put it from the rubble in Biloxi, Mississippi, this is a disaster of biblical proportions. Paul and Karen Redliner, along with our national network and the many supporters of the Children's Health Fund, understood we needed to help. Medical and support staff from 13 Children's Health Fund sites came to the Gulf, where they worked side by side with local medical teams and disaster response officials.
And it's open. Yeah. There you go.
And since Katrina, more than 15,000 health and mental health encounters have been provided by our teams.
Just happy being you.
And in fact, we're there to stay. The Children's Health Fund created 3 permanent programs using 5 new mobile medical units in partnerships with Family Health Center in Mississippi and with Tulane and LSU Medical Schools in New Orleans and Baton Rouge, Louisiana. But we needed to know more about the conditions and the environment that were keeping children at risk. So Operation Assist was created by the Children's Health Fund in partnership with the Mailman School of Public Health at Columbia University. We fielded public health research teams to assess the environmental contaminations of mold and other toxins. We conducted a comprehensive face-to-face assessment of health and mental health conditions among the evacuees. And the studies confirmed our worst fears. Massive health problems. And kids not going to school. And it seems we're now facing what amounts to a second disaster in Katrina's wake for the children in the Gulf.